Probably the biggest weakness of ChatGPT so far was the fact that it was not up to date, but they just changed that. Internet access to GPT-4 users is rolling out this very week, which means you'll finally be able to access the internet from within ChatGPT. As you might realize, this opens up a whole new world of opportunities. All of a sudden, we can run prompts that made no sense up until now. Market research, news stories, content creation that is up to date, and so much more is possible now. All of this is accessible to ChatGPT Plus subscribers, and they'll also be coming out with the code interpreter and plugin soon, but the internet feature is the first thing that landed, and that's what we'll be looking at today. Also, I'm on the road for a job, so don't mind the different environment. Luckily, GPT-4 works from everywhere, so let's see what this thing can do. Okay, so the first thing we need to talk about is how to enable this. It's very simple. Once you go to chat.openai.com, you can go down here and click settings, and under beta features, you can enable web browsing. Beautiful. And now in this brand new interface, you get a drop down on GPT-4, which allows you to access the browsing, which is still in beta. So I'll just click this, and now I'm in browsing mode and I can use GPT-4 with internet access. All right, and this can do a lot. And the problem that I see across social media is that a lot of people just rush to get their content out and they present you with a bunch of half-baked prompts that don't even work properly. Not here. I took my time to test all of these use cases so you can get results immediately. And what I want to show you first is how to upgrade your old prompts to include the internet now. So you might already be familiar with this prompt that creates advertising campaigns. Okay, so as per usual, we could change the words in square brackets, but now that we have internet access, we can expand it so it uses this new functionality. So the first step, I'll change the variables to fit my very own needs here. And that's what we're going to be doing this video. We're going to custom tailor it to my own needs. And I'm going to provide the formulas behind all this in the description below so you can make them your very own. But in my case, I would say, please design an advertising campaign to promote my prompt engineering course targeting AI enthusiasts that are looking to get ahead through the use of technologies. Perfect. So that's just the base prompt filled in. But here's where the browsing feature comes in. I'm going to add the course URL column and then the URL of my sales page. Now when I run it, I'm not just going to get an advertising campaign for a prompt engineering course in general. I'm going to get one based off the facts on the listed that I added here. So I get all the usual stuff that the prompt produces, like the campaign name, but the context is so much deeper now because it can access the web and consider all that information when generating a response. And that's absolutely amazing because when it talks about the key messages, all of these are aware of what's actually offered. And then all the recommendations, all the results are just going to be better because ChatGPT has all the info it needs now. So again, at the end of every prompt, you can now include the subject URL and then post the URL. And now it's going to consider the context of that website within your prompt. Just that alone is such a massive upgrade. Try this with your favorite prompts and thank me later. Okay, so here's my next suggestion that doesn't just expand your old prompts by adding a URL, but really incorporates the concept of GPT-4 having access to the internet into the core prompt. So have a look. Analyze this YouTube channel for video topics, industry niche, and engagement. Then provide content suggestions based on AI news released on the 13th May 2023. Which is today, that's today's date, okay? So first we're gonna analyze this YouTube channel, which we provide with a URL in the end, for three categories that are critical to then providing content suggestions based on AI news released on today's date. And look at these results. This is actually incredible. If you toggle this open, you will see the exact steps it took. So first it looked at the channel, then it used this website that helps with YouTube analysis, and then it found a brand new TechCrunch article released today. This thing was released 1 hour before I ran this prompt. Absolutely amazing work on that front. And then it gives me the answers. First, the analysis of my channel, and then it uses the context of my channel and combines it with the context of the website to get me tailored recommendations for future content. Look, first one, Google's AI advancements at I.O. conference. Yes, perfect. This would be a great potential topic for the channel. And interestingly enough, some of these were even new to me as I didn't read this article yet. So honestly, I might just be doing this every single day from here on out instead of going ahead and reading the news manually. I don't just want the news. I want the news in the context of my YouTube channel and what could be interesting on here. And now if I want to, I can go ahead and click one of these references and hop to the article that it got it from to learn more. But one thing did happen. Once it gave me 10 recommendations, it stopped in the middle of its generation. So simply, I told it keep going. You could also say continue, and it just kept writing the text. So whenever that happens, here's your fix. And then it rounds it out with giving me a bunch of strategies on how to boost my engagement and reach. Like, I absolutely love this so far, but that's not it. I want to show you one more, which even goes a step further than incorporating this browsing feature into the core prompt as we did right now. And this one I literally just finished crafting. So I want to show you the prompt and then the result I got because I ran out of GPT-4 generations on all my accounts, and there's no way I'm going to wait another hour if I can just show you the results like this. So this is the final prompt I would use, okay? And the interesting thing about this one is that it uses an approach that is typical for auto GPTs. If you're not familiar, I covered them in 2 videos on the channel recently, so go catch up on auto GPTs if you haven't done so yet, because that is absolutely where the space is heading and you need to know about them. You don't need to be using them, you need to know about them. So with auto GPTs, you specify a goal and then it gives you the different tasks. And here I'm gonna take the approach of crafting that task list manually, all right? So first I say, here's a task list that you will execute one by one. And then you can give it any number of tasks in the order that you wanted to execute them. So here for the example, I went with 1, find the email addresses for every AI YouTuber with over 50,000 subscribers. 2, using conversational tone and the AI YouTubers as the target audience, write an outreach email introducing me as the owner of the AI Advantage YouTube channel and proposing a potential collaboration. So it's gonna find relevant YouTubers and then write you the email to contact them. And again, this is relatively simple. I just wanna show you the concept as this is kind of a first look at this topic. You could totally prompt engineer this into something that creates customized emails for every single one of the YouTubers. But for now, this should totally suffice. So let me show you the results of this amazing prompt right here. So it starts off by saying, so far I have identified several AI focused YouTube channels with over 50,000 subscribers. And then it gives me this list of all the big AI channels on YouTube. And this already shows a problem here. What I actually meant is generative AI. So I should have specified that in the prompt above, but I just said AI. So nothing changes here. The outputs are only as good as your input. So you have to be very careful with crafting them. But for the sake of this demo, this will do. So now we have 7 big AI channels. Some of them that it didn't get the subscriber counts, because if you open up the toggle, you will find that it accessed various RSS feeds that I would have never thought of using myself. So that's a win right there. And then it goes ahead and writes your subject line and the email that you can use to output all that. And my prompt engineering pro tip would be here, look at the result it generated and use some of the parts that it outlines. For example, it said our mission at AI Advantage. And then it assumes something. If you want to make the prompt better, you would just go ahead and say AI Advantage mission. And then I would insert the mission and now it would consider that while writing the email. And these little clues are always left inside the outputs. And now I can edit my original prompt and by saying save and submit, it will rerun it. Yet another game changing update. And if you don't have ChatGPT Plus yet, honestly, this might just make it worth it even for the casual users, just because it made the language model even more useful now that it has access to up-to-date information. And if you want to go deeper on this, my recommendation would be looking at auto GPTs. I created this video that gives you a beginner's guide on how they work. And if you understand that, you'll be able to get even more out of this browsing feature, as auto GPTs are essentially GPT-4 with browsing enabled on autopilot. I'll see you there.